It's 7 o'clock at Prenti Downs, a cattle station in the center of Western Australia.
Hey, Isabel.
Jack Carmody is checking 38 water points scattered across a million acres.
What have we got just there at the gate?
Look at that one there.
But he doesn't have to rush out to do it.
Let's find your yards. Do we have any cows in Windida Spring?
Yeah.
Here, Isabel, do you want to look? Isabel, do you want to just move the screen like that?
Look at this one.
Click on rock and roll and then click on the little man. And then click on one of your videos. Oh, look, there's a cow right now.
Oh, and another, and another.
Look at him go.
And another, and another. Oh, we got one of our home bulls.
Can we go to the next video now?
Well, this is live. This is right now.
Right now?
Yep, this is right now down at Sweetwater. That's 65 kilometres away.
With technology, Jack has defeated distance. He has set up an intranet system to connect the most remote corners of the station.
Yeah, so, sorry about that. Just put that on silent. As soon as you get close to it, you'll pick up the Wi-Fi. This is a micro pop, or a micro point of presence. And effectively what that does is it takes signal in and then spreads signal out to the far reaches of the station. As we saw, we've got internet connectivity here. And what it allows those remote sites to do is have internet, but also sends the video feed back through here all the way to the homestead and to the cloud.
With cameras at every water point across 1 million acres and self-mastering yards with gates that can be controlled remotely, Prenti Downs may very well be the biggest smart home in Australia.
Do you want to tell Google to open the spring gate?
Hey Google, turn on spring gate.
All right, turning spring gate on.
The wireless connectivity that we're providing across the station, it's just like any residential internet connection.
Even at more than 1 hour drive from the homestead.
That is some awesome connectivity, Ant.
Okay, tell me.
Well, we've got a ping of 65.
65 which is what?
65 milliseconds to Perth.
Okay.
Which is good enough for computer games.
Right, that's a latency.
Yeah, that's our latency.
Yeah.
And we've got a 26 meg down, which is enough to stream in full high definition, if not 4K.
So I can sit down here and watch the cricket, Jack. So
yeah, we could.
But there are bigger benefits.
So having the surveillance allows us to look at and assess the animals. And from that visual data, we're able to take action based on the condition of the livestock.
Or on the number of animals grazing.
It actually allows you to see and assess the total grazing pressure at your water point because everything needs to drink. So we can identify if there's a surge in animal populations, such as overgrazing through non-profitable grazers. And that can include your kangaroos, camels, horses, donkeys, what other ferals you have.
With cameras, water points are constantly monitored.
Put a new panel in.
And any leaks are spotted as soon as they form.
The tank split at Parsons. We've got tank indicating full, but it looks like the leak's coming from underneath it.
With these set up, help can come from hundreds of kilometres away. In this case, from Jack's dad, watching from his farm in Esperance.
If you jump on the camera now.
Don't forget, I've got slow internet here.
Yeah, the internet in Esperance is slower than we have at the station. And you can see where the seam is on the tank.
Yeah, see the tank seam. Yeah. So you got the vertical seam running down.
Yeah, and that's where we've got our lake coming out.
Yeah, look, my suspicion is they're not cleared properly underneath. You can have it, you know, eventually rub through underneath, and I'm suspecting that's what's happened there.
On a remote station, like in other places, technology cuts travel.
Some of the big environmental considerations and benefits to having a system like this is that you've got a lower impact on the land. If you're not driving around all the time, you're going to be able to save fuel, which means that you've got less carbon emissions. Now, in a farming operation, fuel can be one of the highest costs. You're also looking at your labour costs.
Lift your feet up.
And Jack can be there for his family. Even when he's not physically there.
One of the biggest changes and implications that that good connectivity has is actually more the peace of mind for Jasmine and the girls, that they know that they can reach me during the day if something goes wrong.
Everyone on the station is safer.
The advantage of having the video feed gives us a record if there's an incident in the yards, say someone's injured, but when you've got a video feed that covers the yards, the camera doesn't forget, and you can see exactly what happened. And you can do a good post-diagnostic on why it happened, what you can do in the future to prevent it from happening.
And for travellers from the surrounding remote Aboriginal communities, Prenti Downs is one of the safest stretches of the journey.
One of my families travelled through from Warburton, and he broke down at one of the windmills, and they knew, so they drove out to him, and when they got there, they told him, "Oh, we seen you on the camera," and he was surprised, and he said, "Ah."
You're coming in as well, mate.
Not just protecting people, but also their heritage sites.
They disconnected this, or they disconnected
that? That's the end. Yeah, which takes a little bit to actually do that. There's no chew marks from
No.
Very recently, we've had some artifact hunters, and we informed them that no, there is video surveillance, so don't try it. As soon as they got outside of the camera surveillance area, they decided to deviate and go hunting for artifacts somewhere else on another station.
Makes me feel angry. You know, it's just the same as someone just breaking into your, you know, backyard or your house without even asking, you know, without knocking on the door and talking to you first. They're just walking in and just doing whatever they want, you know, and people should have respect for us.
Due to some of the new mapping software that the state government has now made available to all members of the public, unfortunately, that data is now more available, and it's leading to people being able to go artifact hunting. The implementation of this system helps protect those culturally sensitive sites and ensure that those sites are protected for generations to come.
It's one of the reasons why others are looking at implementing similar technology.
So our western, and from here, northern neighbour is Windidda. So that's owned by the Windidda Aboriginal Corporation. One of the things that they've expressed interest in is implementing the same wireless monitoring system on that station.
It will really help us, it'll benefit us, because then it'll help us to keep an eye.
Jack, who used to work in technology, has built this intranet system by himself.
We had to go from scratch with what power supply systems we're using and then the componentry, but the fundamental part of the system has remained the same, the wireless network, the fixed wireless network.
Quality cow cam, all right. Like Mission Impossible.
Simply said, this has to happen. It needs to happen because it makes sense as a business to reduce your costs.
But not everyone shares Jack's view.
In the centre of Western Australia, this remote cattle station has conquered distance, but it's still battling to convince others that this model can work.
When I'd applied for funding to demonstrate this technology, not only here on Prenti Downs, but on another station, was that I received feedback that said that the assessment panel did not believe that it was technically feasible, despite having a demonstrable pilot program where we already had the wireless remote controlled gate as well as an 80 kilometre over the air link.
The initial investment, which he says was in the hundreds of thousands, is not the only barrier that stops this technology from becoming more common.
It's not being promoted by the industry itself. And by the industry, I'm talking about the supporting sides of it, such as from the government through grant programs, outreach programs, and also just training to teach people that they can do it.
Good to go.
But Jack is pushing forward.
Looking at where we can go now that we've got connectivity is very exciting. We can actually use that data in conjunction with developers to implement machine learning technology, and the sky's the limit there.
He dreams of sharing this technology and data with other stations across Australia.
And then from there, we'd be able to start looking at data analysis at a broader spectrum and across similar geographic zones.
So it's really good.
For now, Jack is sharing his connectivity journey on YouTube.
What it allows us to do is connect with the outside world and everyone else to actually connect with Prenti and the land that we work on. It's a really good two-way conversation that we have, and it's really great to engage with the audience themselves.
Their feedback proved precious.
One of the strongest things for agriculture and for pastoralism here in Australia is to have outside eyes on it. And you've got new light through old windows.
There you go.
Connectivity also opens new doors for Jack's daughters.
Right, let's find a soft one, Missy. With the young generation today, connectivity is vital to their social well-being, and having access to high-quality internet out in remote stations is vital. Look at that smile, eh?
And Jack hopes he will keep his daughters working on the land.
Something to really hold on to and remember that we may be remote, but we're not isolated. Because having that good communication removes that isolation.
You're enjoying this, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Can't half tell.